All right, guys, it's a nice one. Look at the colors, man. Got them on that Live Target lipless crank, shiner. It's nice. Nice guy, nice little fight. There he goes, lipless crank. I wasn't getting nothing on it by Live Target. They make great stuff. I wasn't getting nothing on it. I was about to switch off, lipless crankbait off, but I mean, he slammed it hard. He really wanted it, so. I guess we'll stay with it for a little bit. Man. That was fun. I switch to a worm now. Let's see what we can get on that. Just Texas rigging weightless. Letting it sink. Casting parallel to the bank. I'm watching the fish swim back and forth parallel, so. Got one. Oh, he let it go. He let it go. Come on, get it again. Get it again. That was so awesome. Right off the bank, I threw it and he... Oh my god. There, I set the hook that time. He didn't get in the way. No, 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 no. Come on, little guy. Come on. Come on. Gotcha. Got you. Oh, look at that. Right off the bank. That was awesome, dude. Bass. This is a beautiful, beautiful bass. Look at the colors. Oh, my God. God, he is a healthy looking fish. That is a beautiful, beautiful bass. Yeah. I missed him the first time. He ran off with it. So I let it sit there and you let it sink. Don't move it after they take it. Just let it sit where they took it and left it. Give it a split second. They'll come back for it. You know, if they didn't get hooked really good, or they might come back for it. You know, a lot of times they do come back for it. So give it that second chance. You might get them again. Just, and then also, if you know, if you leave it there and they don't come back, throw it back in that same spot a couple more times, because they might come back looking. That was awesome. That was so cool to see that. What I did was with this worm, I dipped the end of it in the spike it. It's like a garlic scent, but it's a red blood color. So it kind of, not only do you get that garlic scent, it looks like a dead, dying bait fish or something in the water. I can't resist it as well. Got one. Oh, got one. Got one, got one, got one. Come on. Come here, little guy. He's just a good fighter. Not really big. Just a really nice fighter. Yeah. He's all right. He's a good solid chunk. Look at that. That was nice. Nice fish. Look at that. He's been caught before in his nose. He's got a hole through it. That's what I like to see, catch and release. Man, all these fish in here, the colors, look at these colors, are just absolutely
nice
gorgeous.
Dark colors.
It means they're into the algae and the greeneries and the water really good, you know? And the dark colors like that. They are healthy. Healthy, healthy fish in here, and that's what I love to see. There he goes. Stand here by the tree and plopped it in, and he grabbed it. Sometimes that's all you have to do. By a shaded tree like this. Or lay down where it's shaded. Just stand there. You're nice and shaded, kept away from the heat and the sun. So you'll be nice and cool and you could stand there for a while and just keep plopping it in. See what you come out with. You never know. You come out with a nice one like that. I thought he was a dink, a small one at first, but he wasn't that bad at all. There we go. Oh. Oh, it's a little baby, like a bluegill or something. Oh, there's a couple of them coming over, surrounding my worm. I don't know if you guys can see this. There's like three or four right there. They give you those quick bites, you know, make you feel like, you know, you got a good fish on first. You know, and sometimes you want to change it up. You know, if they're not biting, say you have like, you know, like I do a Texas, weightless Texas Redon or whatever, and they're not biting, well, that doesn't mean, well, you know, they don't want a worm today. It just might mean you want to change up the presentation. So you might want to switch it over to maybe a weightless wacky, or I mean a wacky rig. You know, maybe you want to change it over to a wacky instead of the weightless Texas rig. Or maybe you want it to be weightless. You just want it to be a regular Texas rig, you know, with the weight in the beginning, with a little weight to punch through, so maybe they're a little deeper. You know, maybe it's just the presentation or the change-up of that bait or lure that you have to do. It never means that, you know, they don't want that completely, you know. Fish are very finicky, especially bass. Yes. Then you have the other fun of catching them. Because now you found out what they're biting on, now you can have fun catching them. So. Like today, I started out, I came out here with the Live Target lipless Shiner crankbait, and wasn't getting nothing all morning, nothing, until that really nice solid chunk towards the end when I was just about to change the lure. Bam, I got bit on. So I said, let me try it a little longer. You know, and I ended up getting nothing, but so then I, all right, so let me switch over. Maybe they want a worm or something. So I had this one tied on already from when I was fishing before and in a different pond. So I tried it out, and sure enough, I got a couple of nice fish on. All right, guys, this is where I'm going to end it. Just a short video today, nothing big. Like I said, I've been doing a lot of writing lately, and I wanted to get out of the house and do a little fishing, have a little fun. I was being a little cooped up, so I decided to come out and try that lipless crankbait by Live Target and see what I got on it. I really didn't catch anything on it before. So I caught that nice fish, so that was nice. And then, you know, I switched over to the worm, and we caught a few more fish, so, you know, ended up being a pretty good day. That's all I was doing, guys. Nothing big. It's a beautiful day. Just wanted to get out. So, we ended up catching a nice few fish. So now I'm going to go home, jump in my pool, get cooled off, because it is hot. And then finish my writing, my article for Roland Martin, the interview I did with him. So I'll finish that up. So be sure to, I'll let you guys know. I'll keep you posted when to find that. When it's published, I'll let you know. And you guys check that out. But stay cool out there, guys. We're getting in this big heat wave coming, especially around where I live in Illinois.